Hey, Roy Marsh here. I'm with Brian Urban, and we are going to cover a way to, when he has us in a tight side, tight half guard, getting to a position where we can fight for. Okay, so a couple things you have to understand. When I'm on the bottom, the things I can use in my favor are structures, my strength, and my movement. Okay? When he has a tight side, tight half guard here, and he's gotten inside all my structures, I don't have the structures anymore. He's beaten me. He's got a good, solid one. This is why it's hard to get him off of me. Okay? If I just try to use strength, it's going to be very hard to push him away. Okay? I don't have... That's my weakest thing. It's going to cost a lot of energy. So what I have to look at is my movement. Okay? Here. I need to look at my movement so that I can make space. There's always going to be a weakness and a hole in whatever structure he builds. So if I can figure that out, where that is, I can manipulate that, and then I can start to maybe destructure whatever he's built. Okay, so the first thing I personally want to do is get this inside elbow in. Okay, he's tight here, so it's going to be very hard for me to bring my elbow. Okay, so I'm going to do a couple things here. One is, if I just try to pull my elbow in this way, my elbow's actually turned out. I want to turn my pinky towards him. So I'm rotating my hand. This brings my elbow closer to my body. Now what I can do is use my bicep, my arm is straight, push him a little bit this way as I pull my elbow. Here. Once I come here, don't cup on his hips, cup on his hip. Okay? Now from here, his hand, I'm just going to put my hand in the middle of his back and grab the claw. I don't need to go way down and I don't want to be way up. I'm going to be right here. Now, can you come around on the other side, please? From here, he's got me very tight in the upper body. This is not where I can move. But because he's holding up tight, there's a space down here. This is my opening. This is where I can make my movement happen. Okay, he's not controlling this hip. He's blocked my other hip, he's blocked both shoulders, but this hip is free. So this is where I'm gonna move. So when I unlock my guard, my half guard, first thing I do is I'm gonna stiff arm him away. Okay? I'm not really trying to push him just so much to make sure he can't follow me when I go to move. Now I'm going to unlock my guard and I want to turn these bottom toes towards the mat. If I just unlock my guard like this and he windshield wipers his leg out, he can come over the top of my. So I want to make sure that my toes are dug in the mat. I'm going to post my foot on the mat. I'm going to keep it up frame so he can't follow me. I'm going to bring my hips out. Now this knee is going to turn and glide over this space that I just said. I'm just going to cross my toes. You don't have to go very aggressively in. I'm not going to cross my feet, I'm crossing my toes. So now I've got this wedge between us. I started building my own structure. Okay? So this means he can't follow me anymore. I've got this hand on the hip, this hand holding the knee, and this knee in between us. So the only thing left in his structure is his hand behind my back. So now I'm going to use my back. This is his arm. Okay? My back is always going to be stronger than his arm. I'm basically going to do a deadlift motion and stretch my back away until his arm grips broke. From here, okay, I can now bring this hand back in front of us. Okay? I'm either going to bring my hand in front of his neck, not by going this way where he could start reaching for a kilo, okay, but by bringing my hand this way. I can also go this way, bring my elbow underneath, start coming underneath, maybe for more of a conditional than half way. Okay? One more time. He's got me super flattened out. I'm here. Okay. First thing on this side, I'm going to turn my hand in. That pinches my elbow towards my body, which makes it fit into that groove of his hip. I'm going to give a slight push on his head, okay, to take a little bit of pressure off this shoulder, which allows me to pull this shoulder back in a little bit. So I'm here. My hand is on his hip, not his ribs, because I need to push him down towards my hips, my legs. I'm going to grab the claw, lock my arms as best I can, unlock my guard with my toes on the mat, move my hips away, bring my knee in, cross my toes. From here, I'm not laying on my back. I want to make sure that I'm stretching my bottom shoulder away, not my top shoulder, and doing this. So I'm keeping the pressure, I break the grip, hand box his arm if I need to, other hand here. And like the other video we've done now, I can come to this position, sit up,
stand, and we're right back into our fetal position. Okay.
So I know a lot of people will get stuck in that tight half guard position, so maybe this is a little help for you to understand some of the ways it might make it easier for you guys to get out. Thank you guys.